Hi, I'm Jeff Stokes. Welcome to Jeff's Daily Dose of Encouragement. Today I want to encourage you not to have misguided loyalties. In the book of Judges, I'm still reading a follow-on from yesterday about the horrific story of the concubine that was raped and murdered, and the Levite who was her husband, cut her up in pieces and sent her to all Israel. Then he met with the men of Israel and they decided that they would go and do justice and sort out what was going to go on and punish the guys that did this. So they went up to Gibeah in Benjamin, and it was down in verse 11 of chapter 20 and following, down to verse 13, it says this: "So all the men of Israel were gathered against the city, knit together as one man." So they were there for war. "And the tribes of Israel sent men through all the tribe of Benjamin, saying, 'What wickedness is this that you have done among you? Now therefore deliver us the men, the children of Belial, which are in Gibeah, that we may put them to death and put away evil from Israel.'" Because actually the law of Israel was, if you murdered someone, and the old covenant law, if you read Leviticus, it might be in Deuteronomy as well, that you were entitled to go and take that person's life. If they get, you know, it was an eye for an eye sort of stuff. So in those days, and the thing is, if someone committed murder, that the punishment was death under the law. And so these people were just going to do justice. But what happened was the children of Benjamin would not hearken to the voice of their brethren, the children of Israel. So they, even though these guys had done absolutely heinous stuff, they were still protecting them. Because why? Because they were Benjamites like them, and they were just protecting them because they were their brothers. And so this is where misguided loyalties come in. And what happened, what ensued because of that, was a massive war. And to start with, Israel attacked Benjamin because of that and lost 22,000 men. Then they had another go and they lost 18,000. And then after that, the third time, Benjamin ended up losing 25,000. A lot of people died just because these people had misguided loyalties, instead of just handing these people over and justice being done. And we've got to be careful of that too. There's a lot of churches whereby there's been, you know, massive investigations and things like that, church denominations and things like that, where a lot of sin has happened and they've tried to cover it up and even deny it and protect the people that have done it, and years and years and years later, there's these, like in New Zealand where I live, there's these big inquiries going on because of people that have suffered abuse in state care, but also in institutions that may have been sponsored by the state but looked after people. And for years and years and years, it's all just been put under the carpet. And what tends to happen, it happens in lots of different professions too. In the police often, or even I've noticed it amongst teachers, that if something happens and you make a complaint or something like that, they'll tend to rally around one another and protect one another, rightly or wrongly. And then there's that misguided loyalty. Instead of just saying, really investigating something and saying, this is what happened or that is what happened, and then the right process is happening, they'll cover it up. It seems to be human nature. But let's not be like that. The Lord's not like that. He, you know, sin will end up being exposed one day. So we can't just cover stuff up. And sometimes it can be like we have had in our country some really serious murders of very young children, babies, and the police have not been able to prosecute anyone because the families, the particular families and the culture that they live in, they all collude together and they cover up and they protect the person that did it, and it never comes out. And it's just wrong. So, but God brings things out there. He's a God. He's the person that brings out in the open. The proverb says, "Be sure your sin will surely find you out." You can't cover anything up from God. You can't hide it. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwells in him and he in God. And 1 John 1:9 says, if you confess your sins, we're in the New Testament now, with Jesus Christ died for sin and paid the penalty for the law and broke the curse of the law, which was death. And now you can come freely to him. And if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. But we don't necessarily escape the consequences of our sin, in which, depending on the legal jurisdiction you're in, there'll be different punishments for that. That may be that some people have to pay the price for what they've done in that way, but it won't be necessarily put to death. So anyway, let's not have misguided loyalties. We have to be upfront. It can save a whole lot more carnage down the track. God bless you. Have a great day.